Hi, my friends. We are here again with a new Spanish class. Today we are going to be studying personal pronouns and some other expressions, greeting expressions. If we have time, this class will be a little short, but we will try to do the best and explain you how to pronounce, how to write in case when you have to write, and how to read and use all these expressions and words.
All right. Before we continue, I want to explain you all this word here, yo, that's a Spanish word. Between bracket, we have a next word. This is how you all are supposed to pronounce in English as an English speaker when you read this word. And this is what it means in English, right? So as an English speaker, when you read this, you might say yo, right? But you must remember when the Y is before a vowel, you pronounce like J, right? So that's why we pronounce in here yo. So this is it's not accurate, but it is something I like how we must pronounce this word, yo, yo, I, tú, tú. When you see this word, you remember this word in English and you have an average idea how to pronounce it. Tú, you, él, él, he, ella, ella, she. The reason why we say in Asia instead of ella, like in English, because when you have double L before a vowel in Spanish, you pronounce ya again, like the J, right? So we have pronombres personales, personal pronouns. We're reading it backwards in Spanish. So we have yo, I, tú, you, él, he, ella, she, ella, yo. Y before vowel sounds like J, double L before vowel sounds like J. Yo, tú, él, ella. Alright, so we continue here. Nosotros. Nosotros, that is we. Ustedes, ustedes, you all. Ellas, this one is ella, this one have an S at the end, means it's plural. Ellas is they, when we're talking about female, like girls and women, ellas, the girls, the ladies. Ellos is male for they. Ellos, they, male. Ellas, they, female. Right? Nosotros, we. Ustedes, you all. Ellas, they, the girls, ladies. Ellos, ellos, they, the boy, the man, male, right? So we have here two words again. Tú is equal usted. Tú, usted means the same. Sometimes we use the word tú, sometimes we use usted. So in Spanish, if you use in a formal way, you're using usted. When you're talking to a senior person, like your teacher, your boss, or somebody you don't know very well, you could use usted. This is the formal way. Informal, when it is your friend or something very related or close by you, you could say tú. Alright? Alright. We are going to continue here with greeting expressions. Expresiones de saludo. Expresiones de saludo. Greeting expression. Saludo means greeting. Expression, expresiones. Alright. So we have the more common and more useful expressions. We have buenos días. Buenos días. This for good morning. From in the morning until 12 o'clock. Buenas tardes. Buenas tardes. We use buenas tardes after 12 o'clock until 6 o'clock. Buenas noches. Buenas noches. We use buenas noches for good night. And this is after 6. We don't use good evening. We don't have the expression in Spanish. We go direct to night. So we have again buenos días, good morning. Buenas tardes, good afternoon. Buenas noches, good night. This expression is a common expression. Simple, like saying good day, buen día. Buen is good, día is day, buen día. So this good day you could use the whole day from in the morning until the evening. So you say good day in the morning, in the afternoon. When it is night, you say good night. Buenas noches. Buenos días. Buenas tardes. Buenas noches. Buen día. All right, I have something curious here. If you notice, we have buenos and buenas. When we have this O, it is, believe it that we use it this as it is a female word, referring to a female word. So when you have A is a female, sorry, the A is a female, the O is a male. Buenos means that something, we talking about something with this male. Buenas is female, right? But this is our plural. So that when we say buenos días in Spanish, means that the expression is a male expression. So when you say buenas tardes, buenas noches, tardes and noches in Spanish is supposed to be female. So días considered as male. Okay? Here we have these words, buenos. Buenos. Buenos means good when we're referring to a group of things. When it is plural, we say buenos. If we're referring to a male object, if the object is supposed to be a female, we use buenas. Right? This is plural. So the single way now is bueno for male, buena for female. Bueno, buena. Buen means good. This is for everybody. And bien. Alright. How we use all these words, all of them means good. Plural, singular, female, and male. How to know when to use each of them, right? When you have plurals before a sentence, you say buenos, for example, buenos días. When you say buenos, means that you will continue saying something else. Buenas, you continue saying something else. Buenas tardes, buenos días. You can say buenos or buenas and stop. When you want to stop and simple say good and nothing else, you say bueno. Bueno. You can say bueno, then say días or noches or tardes. You can't continue the sentence after you say bueno. The same when you're using bien. When you say bien, that is it. End of the sentence. You can't continue like saying bien día, bien noche. That is completely wrong. You might say bien or else bueno when you answer something, how are you? You say bien, simple so. Bueno, all right? So we have buenos, buenos, buenas, and continued expression when it is plural, male and female, male and female, bueno, buena, bien. When you say buen, you continue the expression, like here, buen día. This is singular, this is not plural, right? Buena, buena tarde. No, we don't say buena tarde, we say buenas tardes. Buena casa, a good house, right? If we use in casa, like houses, say buenas casas, plural. If it is only one, you say buena casa, good house, good houses. Bueno is just good. Buenos carros. Carro means vehicle. Buen carro is good car. But you're talking about single. There's only one car. Like here, only one day. Buen día. It's only one day. When you're referring to plural, like buenos días, it's many days. You use buenos with a plural. You use buen with a singular. Buenos, buen, supposed to be male. Buenas, buenas tardes, buenos días, bueno, bien. All right. So here we have some expressions when you want to interact with the person and you want to interrogate the person and know more about this person. When you reach a place, you only say buenos días, buenas tardes, buenas noches. But if you want to interact, continue talking with the person, you use some of these expressions. Expresiones interrogativas, the interrogation expression. ¿Cómo está usted? This is the formal way when you don't know a person, when you're addressing to a senior person, you say, ¿está usted? That is, how are you? ¿Cómo está usted? ¿Cómo le va? ¿Cómo le va? How are you going? This is a formal way. If you want to use this expression in an informal way, you change le by te. ¿Cómo te va? If you don't know the person, or if you're talking to somebody who is a senior person to you, you don't say ¿cómo te va? It sounds like disrespectful. So, ¿cómo le va? How are you? Formal way. ¿Cómo te va? How are you? Informal way. ¿Cómo estás tú? How are you? This is the same here. ¿Cómo está usted? Usted is the formal way. Tú, informal way. This one here and this one here is the same expression. It's just this one is a formal way, this is an informal way. ¿Cómo está usted? How are you? In a respectful way. ¿Cómo estás tú? How are you? In an informal way. To your brother, to your friend, or somebody very close to you. All right. Here we have some ways how to respond a greeting interrogation, like how are you? ¿Cómo estás tú? When somebody asks you, how are you? ¿Cómo estás tú? ¿Cómo está usted? ¿Cómo le va? ¿Cómo le va a usted? You respond in this way. Bien, gracias. Bien, good, thanks. Bien, gracias. Estoy bien, gracias. Estoy means I am. I am good. Thanks. Y tú, that is to ask to the next person how the next person is in behalf. Estoy bien, gracias. Y tú, I am fine. And you, I want to tell you in Spanish, we use the interrogation mark, open and close. Not like in English, we only use closing. In Spanish, you must open and close interrogation mark. Estoy bien, gracias. Y tú, this is the informal way. Y tú, if you want to use the formal way, you say, y usted, estoy bien, gracias. Y usted, this short way, sometimes when you use this short terms, means that you shorten the person, you don't want to continue talking. So when you're busy, when you hurry or something, you just don't want to continue talking, you say, bien, gracias. In a bad mood or maybe in a good mood, but you don't want to go ahead talking with this person because you're busy. You say, estoy bien, gracias. Means that you open to continue talking the next question or something. So the majority of the time when somebody use bien gracias, they will ask you back, how are you? Y tú, bien gracias. Y tú, bien gracias. Y usted, estoy bien gracias. Y usted. When you ask somebody, ¿cómo estás? This person asks you, respond to you, bien gracias, and asks you back, ¿y tú? Or, ¿y usted? You're supposed to say, bien gracias, o estoy bien gracias. Just say the same thing the person said before. ¿Cómo estás? Bien gracias. ¿Y tú? Bien gracias. Estoy bien, gracias. ¿Y usted? Bien, gracias. All right, we will cut this class. We end this class at this point, and we will continue the next time with more expressions, more words, and explain some other new tips. Some clues, how to follow the Spanish, how to pronounce it, why some rules are followed in that way, how that some words are pronounced in this way, and the reason why some letters, consonants are sung in this also way, right? So I hope you enjoy it and you could practice and learn something, and we will see you next time.